Hello and welcome to the product demonstration video of the SIG300. In this video, I will introduce you to the SIG300 and its hardware architecture, so let's get right to it. The SIG300 is an 8-port I/O link master that integrates I/O link devices into higher controller systems like a programmable logic controller, better known as PLC, or to the cloud. It is compatible with 3 fieldbus variants and features 2 IIoT interfaces with REST API and MQTT. With its IP67 housing and an operating temperature range from minus 40 to plus 50 degrees Celsius, the SIG300 provides reliable operation in harsh environments. There are currently 4 different versions of the SIG300, and a programmable version of its hardware is coming soon. For PLC integration environments, the SIG300 is available in EtherCAT, Ethernet IP and Profinet. You can quickly see the version you have by the fieldbus logo on the device cover. The 4th variant of the SIG300 is the REST version for the integration into IT solutions. This version has no fieldbus logo imprinted on the device cover. Now let's take a look at the product from top to bottom. The SIG300 has 2 Ethernet ports, 2 power ports, input and output, 8 sensor ports and an USB-C interface for easy diagnostics. Each port is named and there are illustrations printed on the device cover to help users remember the different interfaces and their pins. Let's take a closer look at each of these ports. The SIG300 features an L-coded 5-pin male power supply interface marked as PWR1. It allows users to supply a load of up to 16 amps on the device. Next to the input power port is an L-coded female power out port. With the power out option, other devices can be connected in series to the SIG300 to simplify wiring. As you can see, now we have connected 2 devices in chain. It is important to note that the total current load of your SIG300 and any devices connected in series must be less than 16 amps. Each power supply port has 2 indicating LEDs. The LEDs from the power output indicate the power status of the device. The LED label UA is only available for sensor port S7 and S8. These are Class B ports and are intended to be powered from a separate power supply to provide galvanic isolation. This is important for high-powered actuators and other devices that typically introduce electrical noise to control systems. The second LED, labeled US, indicates the power supply for sensors and internal electronics. The assignment of the LEDs next to the power in give different status depending on the variant of the SIG300. You find more information on the LED assignment in the corresponding operation menu of the SIG300 variant. Above the power supply, every SIG300 variant independent features 2 Ethernet ports marked as P1 and P2. For the EtherCAT, Ethernet IP and Profinet version of the SIG300, the Ethernet ports are bridged, making the devices a dual port network switch. Therefore, the SIG300 can be connected to a PLC system via Ethernet cable through either one of the 2 Ethernet ports. By being a dual port device, it furthermore enables the connection of multiple devices in series, better known as daisy chaining. The Ethernet connection comes in through one Ethernet port and out through the other to the next device. The REST variant of the SIG300 has 2 isolated Ethernet ports, which can be implemented into 2 independent networks at once and acts as a firewall. The LEDs next to each Ethernet port indicate the status of the network connection. If the LED is off, there is no connection to a network. If the LED is green, there is a connection to a network. Beneath the power output port of the SIG300, we also have a USB-C interface marked with config. This configuration port enables quick access to the integrated web user interface on the device. To access the WebUI of the SIG300, connect your PC or laptop to the USB-C interface of the SIG300. And enter the default IP address into your web browser. In the WebUI, the SIG300 can be taken into operation, and furthermore, the SIG300 as well as connected devices can be easily customized and configured. You will also see service and status information of connected IO-Link devices. In the IOD file management, IOD files can be uploaded on the device to provide sensor-specific functionalities. The onboard IOD interpreter makes integration even easier. The integrated logic editor allows data pre-processing without additional PLC programming to even solve applications like fill-level measurements directly on the SIG300. Furthermore, with the new SIG tool Sentry Creator, a scalable and remote configuration can be made over multiple SIG300 devices. Moving on to the next interfaces, here we can see the I/O link ports of the device. As said before, the SIG300 is an 8-port I/O link master. It features 8 I/O link ports with 2 class B and 6 class A ports. The ports are labeled and numbered from S1 to S8. The different pin assignment can be seen in the graphic on the device cover between the ports. But let's take a closer look to the different sensor ports. The ports S7 and S8 are the class B ports, meaning that of the 5 pins, pin 2 and 5 are galvanically isolated and driven by the actuator power supply. Pin 1, 3 and 4 are used for the standard I/O link communication, meaning pin 4 can be used as either digital input, output or for I/O link communication. These ports are especially suitable for the connection of devices requiring a high current supply, such as actuators like valves or bigger signal lights. Next to each sensor port, we can find LEDs indicating the status of the regarding pin. Depending on the port and pin, the LEDs indicate whether the pin is used for I/O link communication or as a digital input or output. In the case of sensor port S7 and 8, the second LED indicates whether pin 2 is used as an extra power supply for the connected device. For example, have a look at sensor port S7. If pin 2 is used as an extra power supply, the regarding LED turns yellow. Please refer to the operation manual of the SIG300 for detailed information about the LED assignment at each port. The ports F5 and F6 are both 5-pin class A ports. Pin 1 and 3 are used for the power supply. Pin 4 is used for either I/O link communication or as a digital in or output. Pin 2 and 5 can be used as either a digital in or output. This means that each of those ports, S5 and S6, can be assigned as 3 digital in or outputs. Port S1 to S4 are 4-pin class A ports. Once again, pin 1 and 3 are used for the power supply. Pin 4 can be used as a digital in or output or for I/O link communication. Pin 2 can either be used as a digital in or output, and pin 5 is not in use. Therefore, sensor port S1 to S4 can be configured as a maximum of 2 digital in or outputs each. So in total, we can connect up to 8 I/O link devices to the SIG300 with 8 digital inputs or outputs, or 16 digital inputs or outputs if no I/O link devices are connected. So this was it, this was a short introduction to the SIG300. If you're interested, please be sure to visit SIG.com or check out the other videos in this series.